On the 2nd December 2022, the US Air Force unveiled the long-anticipated and highly classified B-21 Raider. The B-21 will be the world's first 6th-generation combat aircraft, and in this video, we'll be looking at what makes this next-generation stealth bomber worth the billions of dollars it has taken to develop, and whether it's really that much better than the US Air Force's current stealth bomber, the B-2 Spirit. Stealth is probably the most notable characteristic of these aircraft, and the B-2 Spirit is likely the first thing that comes to mind when we think of a stealth bomber. According to pilots and operators of the B-2, it has what they call a variable radar cross-section, which changes depending on the aircraft's loadout and mission, meaning the B-2 Spirit can appear on radar anywhere from 0.1 meters squared in size to 0.75 meters squared. This means to an enemy's radar, the stealth bomber will appear roughly the size of a suitcase, as opposed to its actual dimensions of 69 feet or 21 meters in length, with a wingspan of 172 feet or 52.4 meters. When the B-2 Spirit first took flight in 1989, the Cold War era Soviet radars and jets would find it near impossible to track and lock the American stealth bomber. But 30 years later, radar technology has improved considerably, meaning potential enemies equipped with ASA radars will be able to target, lock and shoot down a B-2 Spirit from roughly 50 miles away, making its primary characteristic near obsolete. This is where the B-21 Raider will come in. The Americans have not given up with the idea of a near invisible bomber, and alongside the 30-year advancement in radar technology, the United States Air Force has continued to adapt and develop its understanding of stealth characteristics. If we look at the current American Air Force's inventory of F-35s and F-22s, we can see that stealth has a pivotal role to play in the mission to achieve air dominance, which we dive deeper into in my previous video, which explores the best fighter jets in the world. Despite no official figures being released, sources claim that the B-21 Raider will achieve a radar cross-section equivalent to or smaller than 0.004 meters squared, around the same size as a bumblebee. The B-21 is expected to be smaller than the B-2 Spirit, with a wingspan of 164 feet or 50 meters and a length of 65 feet or 20 meters. With such a small radar cross-section, the B-21 in theory should not be targetable before coming into a 13-mile proximity of the world's most advanced radars, making it considerably more able to penetrate enemy airspace and conduct its mission. Weapons. Despite the B-21 being smaller than the B-2, its payload is expected to be notably more. Reports estimate that the B-21 will have a maximum payload of around 50,000 pounds, or 22,680 kilograms of drop bombs, guided drop bombs, and nuclear ordnance. When we compare this to the B-2 Spirit's 40,000 pounds, or 18,150 kilo payload, we can see another significant advancement between the two stealth bombers. Weapons-wise, the B-21 has been designed to be armed with the most cutting-edge weapon technology, whilst also being engineered to be easily upgradable, meaning it will be able to deliver the next generation of munitions. Experts predict the B-21 will typically feature long-range standoff missiles, which are next-generation stealth-enhanced nuclear cruise missiles, as well as free-falling nuclear gravity bombs and satellite-guided air-to-surface weapons, such as the JDAM. The US Air Force specifically stated to Northrop Grumman that the B-21 must be built to an open architecture philosophy. This means that its hardware and software must be easily adaptable to turn the aircraft from a bomber, to a surveillance and communications aircraft, to a drone command station, or even to deploy electronic warfare packages, meaning it will be America's first multi-role bomber. Unlike the B-2 Spirit, the B-21 Raider will be able to be manned or unmanned, meaning it can be flown with or without a pilot on board. This means the B-21 can operate for longer periods of time and within more dangerous and contested airspace, without risk to loss of human life. This means the B-21 Raider will be able to beat the B-2's current world record for longest air combat mission of 44 hours, by not having to worry about pilot fatigue within the aircraft. Theoretically speaking, the pros of an unmanned aircraft seemingly outweigh the option to utilize an onboard pilot. But the US Air Force has stated that its aircraft must be able to be manned when potentially deploying nuclear weapons. The B-21's theme of drone technology does not stop with its ability to be deployed without a pilot. the B-21 will be able to act as a command station for loyal wingman drones, which can assist it in its mission. These drones can act as an extension of ordnance, meaning they can assist in the carrying of bombs, act as an escort to tackle potential enemy interceptors, or even act as external fuel tanks by conducting air-to-air refueling. The range of a bomber is a very important factor when judging the performance of these machines. A bomber's ability to cover vast distances to deliver its payload and then return to safety is critical for both mission success and pilot safety. The B-2 Spirit has an unrefueled range of approximately 6,000 nautical miles, with the ability to conduct air-to-air refueling. The B-21 Raider's range is still unconfirmed, but predictions state that it will have an unrefueled range of at least 7,000 nautical miles with the ability to conduct air-to-air refueling. US government representatives have stated that the B-21 Raider will be able to conduct missions from anywhere in the world to anywhere in the world without the need for air-to-air refueling assistance close to the proximity of enemy airspace. Engines. The B-21 is predicted to feature two F-135 Pratt & Whitney engines. These are used in the F-35 and have the ability to be continually upgraded. This will give the B-21 Raider a predicted max speed of at least 620 mph and a surface ceiling of at least 49,213 feet or 15,000 meters, with official numbers expected to be higher. These figures are near identical to the B-2 Spirit, but its predecessor features four engines, making it much less efficient and therefore more expensive to maintain and fly. Cost. The B-21 program is by no means a small feat, and in turn its predicted cost to complete is enormous. Experts predict the B-21 program will cost the US government a sum of $20 billion, with a unit cost per bomber to be in the region of $700 million. These figures are incredible, but when we compare the unit cost to that of the B-2 Spirit, it begins to make a bit more sense. The B-2 Spirit was originally planned to cost the US government roughly $440 million per aircraft, assuming the original order of 132 bombers were to be complete. However, as the order numbers plummeted to just 21 aircraft in total, the cost per aircraft of the B-2 Spirit rose to $2 billion each. This cost accounts for both the research and development investments. The US government has stated that the Air Force will acquire at least 100 B-21 Raiders, learning from its lessons with the B-2, and aims to keep this pledge to decrease the overall unit cost of the B-21 and make the program a better strategic investment. The United States Air Force began planning the B-21 back in 2011 and awarded Northrop Grumman the contract to develop the first sixth-generation aircraft 4 years later in 2015. Air Force representatives have stated that they expect the first flight of the B-21 Raider to take place at some point in 2023, with the B-21 entering active service in 2027. Until then, we will have to wait and see the true capabilities of the world's first sixth-generation aircraft. Thanks for watching this video. Let me know your thoughts on the B-21 Raider and let me know in the comments whether you believe this aircraft will be a worthy successor of the B-2 Spirit. Be sure to check out my previous videos where we look at the best fighter planes ever created, from the Supermarine Spitfire to the MiG-21 to the F-22 Raptor.